in property, you will really make it big if you're the first mover.
Pag ganito magpaparenta ka ng space sa bahay mo, sa garahe mo, ganyan, ano yung presyo o yung rate na gusto? Yung tama lang, yung hindi ka lugi, pero hindi ka rin nang aagrabyado ng kapwa mo.
Sa Pilipinas ba, ang property merong dip?
Marami rin tayo mga tita-tita, tito-tito na medyo senior citizen na sila. Hindi na sila pwedeng lumabas. Pero sila, may property sila. Diba? So pwede ka lumapit sa tito mo at say, tito, lolo, yung property mo, ako na lang mag-aalaga. Ako na lang maglilinis, ako na lang maglalagay sa Facebook. Kasi bata ako, I'm tech savvy, lalagay ko yan sa mga groups ko. Ayan, agagawa ko pa siya ng YouTube tsaka ng TikTok para ma-promote. Marami ngayon mga online seller na napupuno na yung bahay nila sa mga gamit nila, ganun, naghahanap sila ng extra space. Baka naman within your neighborhood, merong ganung online seller na puno na yung bahay niya at naghahanap siya ng extra storage. So check mo yung bahay niyo, baka naman may extra kwarto ka dyan na puro mga nakatambak lang na pwede mo linisin at iparenta mo yung extra space niya. Sabi mo, parenta mo ng kahit 2,000 pesos, 3,000 pesos, di ba? Siya naman, at least sa bahay mo, may bantay rin siya dun sa items niya. What is the secret para mag-make profit ng malaki sa property? I think number one is time, di ba? Number two, the acquisition cost. Yung pagbili mo ng property.
Pagbili ng property.
Andun eh. Yung talagang sinasabi nila, eh, sa property, you make money when you buy. Yun talaga yun. Hindi mo makokontrol yung pagbenta mo eh. But yung pag-buy, yung trip. And number three, direct, if I may add, property, and I guess all business, you need to be a visionary. Diba? Kailangan makita mo yung 10 years down the road, 15 years down the road. Kasi that's what will make you profitable. Eh.
Pag ganito magpaparenta ka ng space sa bahay mo, sa garahe mo, ganyan, ano yung presyo o yung rate na gusto, yung tama lang, yung hindi ka lugi, pero hindi ka rin nang aagrabyado ng kapwa mo.
Here's how you analyze it, paatras. Meaning analyze mo, kung ikaw ang online seller, diba, at naghahanap ka ng space, is 3,000 worth it na? Parang 3,000, parang okay eh. Kasi pag anything higher, parang presyo na yan ng isang studio type eh, na medyo maliit, yes. Di ba? So, yun na, siguro sa gitna ng presyo ng kwarto at ng isang storage space. Tapos isipin mo rin yung itawag nila sa English na sustainable. Sustainable ay meaning, kaya ba bayaran nung tenant mo yung 100 pesos a day? I think 100 pesos a day in 1 month, 3,000, parang affordable. In property, you will really make it big if you're the first mover. Kung una ka, at mararide mo yung, kumaga sa roller coaster, maride mo yung upswing ng todo.
Sa Pilipinas ba, ang property merong dip, bumababa ba? Kasi sa totoo lang, never pa akong naka-experience na bumili ng property tapos bumagsak yung property.
Property as a product, as a character, siguradong pwedeng mangyari, bumaba yung price niya. I think I wanna say that first. Although pwedeng hindi pa nangyayari, historically, but I would always say that's a possibility, especially if the property is not so good. Siguradong babagsak yung price niya. Anything that is overpriced, I think, may potentially mag-correct.
Number four is how to handle complaints. So for example, may mga tenants kasi na masyadong mareklamo talaga. So my advice is in the contract, in your lease contract, you say it's an as-is. Where is basis? So kung ano yung property na yan, yan na yan. Second, there should be a confirmation for that the tenant inspected the property and they're okay with the property. Kasi sometimes, pagdating ng tenant, pag move in nila, biglang, ayoko nito, papalit nito. So before the move in, there should be a confirmation na you inspected the property and you're okay. the lease contract should at least have these provisions. Number one, terms of the lease, which are, of course, the monthly rent, the lease period. Number two, use of the property, whether it's residential or commercial. Third is whether the tenant can assign or sublease the property. Because under the law, if you're silent in this provision, the tenant can actually sublease the property. Fourth will be clause on pre-termination. When can you pre-terminate the contract? So if there's non-payment of monthly rent, for example, you misrepresentation. So for example, if you're renting out a residential property, there's a representation that there would be only 5 members of the family that would live there. Then suddenly you discover that there are 5 individuals living in your property.
Is there a more attractive segment to target right now in 2022 in terms of rentals? So if you will, maybe for yourself or for people watching this, if you're starting from scratch, what will you target?
I think if you are, lagi yan Marv may ganun, na, if you are betting on this, then you do this. If you are betting on this, this will be your strategy. So if you are betting that the university market will go back to school, then university market, I think it's a clear-cut market segment. Diba? That's very clear. Basta, they will stay there for 4 years, maybe galing sila sa probinsya. The target customer is not the student, the target customer is their parents. So you have to make sure your checklist pasado sa parents nila, either it is safe, there's security, there is visiting hours, there's limitation, it's walkable to school, safe in that route. Those are your criteria for your university target market. The most important question is, we as the owner, are we doing anything about it? Are we advertising our property that's available for rent? It's no different from making, for example, Marvin will bake a banana bread, but hindi naman niya na-advertise na he's selling banana bread. So it will not move. So it's not fair to say Marvin Guillermo's banana bread is not selling. Therefore, it's not delicious. Hindi. Because it's not properly advertised.
Most memorable rental opportunity for you?
I think when people ask me, Carl, what is your most memorable rental property? It's definitely the first one.
Okay.
It's my first one that was 1.5 million-ish, somewhere there. Super liit lang na property, off-center in Quezon City. Not high-end, second-hand. I made like 10,000 a month to 12,000. Not so significant amount. But why is it memorable? Because that's where I learned all the strategies. That's where I made my first mistake. And that's where I kind of learned everything so that you can build it up towards having more rental properties and bigger size properties.
If financially, hindi ka naman in excess, diba kung na you're young, you're just barely starting, you just rent, diba? Although sayang pera ang rent, pero kung di naman kasi excessive yung pera mo, rent ka muna. Magsipag ka muna, magtrabaho mabuti hanggang sa ma-increase mo yung income mo. When you reach a point na your income is excessive, diba? At talaga sobra-sobra na, pwede ka na pumasok sa other ventures like business, mag-franchise ka, or pag talagang established ka na talaga, you can now venture into property.